Whoa! I felt that one. Hey guys, welcome to SimUK. This is Farming Simulator 17, and I have been busy getting ready to start my Let's Play series on this. And I started by just downloading a whole bunch of maps that I've found here, there, and everywhere. And today, I'm just going to take you on a little tour of each of them, and then I'm going to pick which one to go on. So let's start with the American Outback. So here we are. This is the American Outback. Look at this, fantastic. Got some cow horns or bull horns and the entrance gate. This is quite a nice entrance gate. Does this work? Doesn't seem that it does. This is looking very nice. Got some nice hills in the background. In fact, everywhere. Mountains, maybe. There might even be mountains. Now, I haven't touched this game basically at all since I bought it. And that's kind of sacrilege, really. I used to have all my buttons bound to something. I can't even remember what my buttons are bound to now. I think it's Q, isn't it? Oh, I haven't got my head tracking on. Let's put head tracking on. I think we're good now. We've got a tractor. I don't really know where I'm going. I'm just going to drive around, have a look. That must be a cactus. Or the biggest corn I've ever seen in my life. So this is kind of the main farm area, I guess. Multiple storage areas, multiple entrance and exits. This is actually pretty nice. I'm not going to adhere to any particular speed restrictions. Nice storage, vehicle storage there. This is obviously a drop-off. Whoa, careful. Looking pretty good. Frosty Delights, I don't know what the heck that's all about, but this must be, I assume, the main drag. Nice water feature to the right. So we've got a garage coming up here too. Decent number of fields and all a decent size. So here is the garage, or the fuel station, I should say. Pretty good. Do I still have any of my keys bound to anything? Okay, well that one just turned off my head tracking. So yes, I do have some stuff bound. Oh wow. This isn't precarious at all, is it? Oh, how easy is it to drive off the edge there then? Very easy. Well, I'm not sure if that's a good thing or a bad thing. Okay, head tracking's back on, that's good. It looks like all of these fields are purchasable. Oh, look, we've got a vehicle. Ridiculous amount of dead zone on my steering wheel. Wow, it's like 30%. That's nearly 45% before it actually registers. That is preposterous. What do we have here? Not sure what this is for. A drop-off of some sort. Hey, look at this bridge. I think that's the end of the map, isn't it? Oh, it's a train track. Oh, that's cool. So, yeah, I say this is pretty nice, actually. Pretty well done. Now, I don't really have any buttons bound here at all. Except that one's obviously the map. Oh, that's that dead zone catching me out. Good number of fields, and they all appear to be pretty much square. So the AI shouldn't have too much trouble with it. Oh, a little town here, look. Every shop looks like a bar. A cakery. And I think the shop might be down here as well. So yeah, it's pretty nice. Oh, that helps a bit. So the shop, I think, is down there. Let's go have a quick look. This is quite pleasant. Quite pleasant. Maybe I should do a video for each map. Very nice. And not too dissimilar to what I would expect to see in an American farm base. Quite impressive. Got some classic American trucks too, which is nice to see. Silos, the silage. It's got pretty much everything we need. Let's just take another look here at the map. I'm assuming there's a bridge here. Yeah, there we go. So I mean, these bridges are dangerous, incredibly dangerous, but it's quite nice. Are there trees down there? What the heck was that? It's quite well laid out, I guess. Looks like we got some crop over here. Nice. Do like your straight roads, don't you? Lots of blocks. Oh, slippage. Got some cannons here. I mean, goodness me, what's this all about? Like the park area or something. So yeah, that's pretty much it, I guess. So that's it, guys. This is the the American map. It's quite nice. It's quite flat, quite nicely managed. There's a good safe area around each of the fields, so it seems. Pretty good. I like this. I like this a lot. It's very nice. So this is Broxton, southwest Cheshire. 40 plus fields, including arable livestock and grass fields. Beware stray sheep and cattle crossing. Wow. I like that little added bit of nugget. I don't think you can actually hit the animals though, can you? We'll find out, I guess. Here we are. Broxton tractors, of course. So I haven't set up my buttons yet. Now, we're in the UK, that's quite cool. Oh, I do like the road signs. Okay, let's just pause here a second and have a look at the map. Figure out where we are. So we're up in the top left hand corner. By the shop. I guess we'll head straight down here, turn left, and then left, and then left. It's quite square, but also not square. Interesting. And there's a bit in the middle there that looks pretty rural to me. So let's go check that out. Oh, momentarily forgot we're in the UK. Trying to drive on the right. There's a nice little station down there. Little bit American looking. That is a very British looking bus stop though. Very nice indeed. Now we've got road signs there telling me that that's the edge of the map. So my indicators are working, that's good. Did I perhaps miss our turning? I'm just checking the map where I'm meant to go. Nope, we're on the right road, that's good. So the roads actually for a British rural area are very wide. And generally you don't get this in Britain. The rural roads are much, 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 much smaller. You need to have little offs like this so that cars can pass each other. That's what you'd expect to see in the UK. I like that ditch though. It's pretty realistic looking. Quite an open area, kind of hilly. At the moment it's pretty nice, but it seems a little too thought out, if you know what I mean. In rural Britain things are kind of mother nature plays quite an important hand. Yep, we want to turn here. Maybe if I keep that map up it will help me. Yeah, Mother Nature plays quite an important role in shaping farms in Britain. Oh, we've got a little bridge here. Hello, little bridge. It goes over the train track. So I'm guessing there's no water on this map. Stop driving on the right. Very British road sign. Although it's got nothing written in it. Oh, this one has. Give way, it should say. Yeah, that's nice. Being a Brit, these things are important to us. Oh, now this is quite nice. This is very good. I mean, this is incredibly realistic. Oh, didn't see that blue car. Quite a busy road. This is very nice. It's just gone up in my estimations for this area. This is very much how you'd expect to see a farm in rural Britain looking. Oh, look, we got a cow sign here. Just want to have a quick look, actually. Just to see what's here. Got some cows over the backfield. Some sheep next to us. Four by four. It's not a Land Rover though, so it's not that accurate. I thought I might be able to get back out the other side, but apparently not. Not bad. This bit is especially nice. You can kind of go off-road down there, the side there. It's another British type scenario. More sheep over there. FPS is taking a bit of a hit. It's not actually, FPS is 60. Just a bit stuttery. Now, are these gates... Oh yes, very nice. Oh yeah, I've also got repair costs on. How do I keep the gate open? Oh, I see, it's fully automatic. All right. Let's go have a look over here, I guess. Ah, water feature. Nice. Very nice. Muddy ditch. Just take a quick look at the map. Where are we? I guess we can go left. Go up here and see what that very rural looking area is. Sheep don't appear to be moving very much. Should I be concerned? This is nice. That's a rural British bit of road right there. Nice and accurate. This looks pretty good down here, actually. Some areas of this map are very good, and some areas of the map not quite so good. But overall, I do actually like this. This is quite impressive. Just a bit too well thought out. It's not hickety-pickety enough for my liking. But I do like it. I genuinely do like it. Now this is more like it. Single track roads. Still a little bit too wide for the British countryside. Oh, what have we got down here? Church. And I can hear church bells. That's a nice touch. Bit of a shame there's no way into the church, though. So, silage down here. It's a good space. Whoops. Is this the town? Kind of towny area. Crisp factory. Windsors. That's a nice play on Walkers. Except I have to tell you that Walkers are not a British crisp company. They're an American company. Pretending to be a British company. Walkers possibly are the most liked crisp in Britain. I think that's pretty fair to say. I'm completely not where I thought I was. What's going on here? Right, we'll go all the way up. It's down there, that's a dead end. Is the church again. So this is a dead end up here, apparently. Is it? It certainly doesn't look like one. I think that dead end sign might be in the wrong place. Blickton Hill, or something along those lines. Let's check it out. Random logs. Ministry of Defence training area, public access permitted. What? Oh, public access permitted, please keep to paths. That's quite realistic. Oh, I see. We're at the edge of the map. Access is not permitted. Okay. Pretty nice. Let's swing down over to the rural area so we can take a shortcut. Two wheels. This is kind of nice, I guess, this bit. Let's get a better view. I wish I could remember how to get these flipping information stuff off. Is it this one? No. Here we go then. Bit of water over there. So this is okay, this is not too bad. It's not wowing me, it's not stunning. But it's well laid out, it's functional. Plenty of space, lots to do. To see. Greenhouse. Oh. So that's it, guys. I'm pretty much going to call that a day on this one. It's not bad at all. I think it could be improved. And overall, though, I like it very much. Very much indeed. We've done the American Outback, we've done Broxton. Chellington 17 version 2. Welcome to Chellington, which is an area in Bedfordshire. The map is fictional, containing 20 fields, including arable livestock and a few grass fields. Sounds pretty straightforward. The picture looks nice. Okay, this is nice. That's very nicely done. Go jump in this tractor over here. What do we have? What are we provided with? Massey Ferguson 7719 Diner 6. Alright then. Let's have a look at the map. Quite a small little map. Looks like we're going to come out of here, turn left, and then left again, and just do a tour. Automatic gate. Certainly not. Oh, the gate's going to open in. Yeah, they are. Whoops. That was the wrong place for it. Okay, slight technical issue there. Let's continue a. Let's go left. Now, this is what I was talking about previously. The roads are much, much tighter. I know there's no AI traffic, so it's not as realistic. But oh, tomatoes and poppies, very nice. That looks like a British garden to me. Two bins, two green wheelie bins there, and a barbecue, an unloved barbecue. That's a British... Whoa! I am sorry. I haven't got used to this stupid dead zone. Yeah, you beep at me all you want, mate. So this is quite nice. Yeah, this is pretty good. Got to kill this dead zone. It is driving me mad. Can't drive properly. Turn that off. Must only be able to do that in the main menu. Oh crikey, look at these guys. But this is more realistic, having to pull over to one side in order to let cars through. That's what you expect from a British based location. It's nice and hilly. It's far more undulating than the other map, the last map. Looks pretty good to me. There's a bridge there. I'm not going to the bridge. Is that for the train? Holy cow! This dead zone is absolutely doing my head in. Come on now. good old British bridge-ish, kind of. Not sure that building over there is. What's that, a flipping elephant sticking out the top of it? Oh, there's a little forestry area down there. Ah, oh, is there a car behind me? You pillar. Alrighty. British Road Signs. New Holland Agriculture. What do we have in here? Oh, this is where the animals would live. Our livestock. And a little tucked out of the way hidey hole type thing. Which is nice as well. Gravy. Gonna take a quick look at that forest. Not too bad at all. Not that heavily populated there, I must say. A decent area nonetheless. Take a risk. Oh! Almost didn't pay off. But I was trying to sit a bit lower down in the seat. Oh, look at this. Church with a graveyard, that's quite impressive. And this one has a gate to get in. A nice 18th century, 17th century thatched roof house, that's nice. Telephone box, British looking, oh this is good. This is nice in terms of Britishness. At the pub? Is that the pub? You generally seem to find pubs, yeah. The plough, that was called, of course. Come on, fella. Let me out. I think I've got a motorbike stuck under my wheels. Can I continue? Oh, nothing there. Okay. Just being weird. Oh, wow, a castle. How do we get over there? Nice! Can we just... Yeah! Excellent. Need to figure a way to get out of here, but this is nice. I like this. This gives it some real character. See. Let's take a little look. Oh yeah. What a nice addition this is. This is good. This is my favourite right now. If for no other reason than just because of this. This is delightful. Totally unexpected, but very well liked. You can't actually go in there, can you? You can. Oh, that's delightful. such a shame you can't walk the way up to the top, but in reality, that's actually what it's like with these ruins quite often. How nice is this? That's impressive. I like that a great deal. Nice work. That is nice. Okay. See if we can get this Massey out of here. Oh, bouncy. Bouncy, bouncy. Now, if I remember rightly, these gates are not automatic. So we're going to have to open it, which is a good thing. Very nice indeed. Quick look at the map to see where we are. So we go left and left, we'll find the shop. Super. Hey, this is nice as well. Little country lane. Very, very well done. This map just oozes Britishness. Very good. I like it. And that feature there, that's just totally made it for me. Amazing. I want to get that field. Very nice. Delightful. Most pleasant. It was a bit dangerous. Logging area. Go on then, little white car. Where are you? Oh, you took too long. You took too long. Sorry, fella. Okay, so generally we find that bridges are edge of the map markers. Oh, there's a working windmill. Oh, nice. Now, have I gone the wrong way here? Yeah, looks like I have. Not sure what that was over there. I have to get the steering sorted out. I've turned so far just for the smallest adjustment. Goodness sakes. I'm not using a controller, I'm using a proper grown-up steering wheel. Don't need these micro adjustments to be ruled out. That is stunning. Absolutely stunning. Really nicely done. What do we have here? Oh, that's the church again. So yeah, this is motorbike's fallen over. These are very good as well. These look like old Cornish houses, to be perfectly honest. So that's it. Have we done the tour? I think we have, haven't we? More or less. We'll go to the shop. That's where we turned off just now. So we'll go to the shop and we'll call that a day. But this is, it's small, but it's nicely done. And it's got that fantastic central feature in it. That's really nice. Very much like what I'm seeing. Is this the shop? This is the shop. So we've been here before already. It is small, isn't it? Very nice map. Very tidy, very neat. Yeah, impressed. Very impressed. So far, we have checked out the American Outback, Broxton, Chellington 17 V2, with the fantastic castle. And this is Coldborough Farm. Now, this is one I absolutely adored on 2015. But never got to play it. Just ran out of time. If you're an early adopter to Sim UK, you'll see that the channel predominantly was farming and flying. Oh yeah, this is very nice. This is pretty much identical. In fact, it looks identical. So we'll hop in here, bounce down the road. Jump in the case. Yeah, this is very tidy Coldborough farm. And these gates, they all open, a manual opening, I think. They were in 15, I think. So we've got a little chute down here, and then we come to the main road. But it's undulating, very nice. There's a nice house to our left. Oh, to be a farmer in real life. Oh, this is new. I don't recall seeing a fence, a gate here before. It's probably a good idea. Which way is it opening? Towards me, of course. There we go then. Now, I kind of forget which way to go, but I think it's kind of a loop. Where am I? So let's go right, first, left, down to the bottom, and left. The road signs are looking very good. I think up here at the top is the sheep. Let's go check out the sheep, I suppose, and then we can come back. Ah, UK, not America. Well, I should say UK, not the rest of the world. This is Chantry Farm, where they deal with livestock. Very nicely done. Cattle grill. Should find some chickens around here somewhere. Oh, let's hop out of the case. Go check out this Massey. I think it's a Massey, is it? Let's jump in. MF 5600. Oh, start the engine. Nice. Well, this has changed a little bit, I suppose, to accommodate the new sheep or the new livestock features. Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. Fantastic. Could do with giving this one a wash. Oh, the steering is crazy. This is pleasant. This is nice. Now, unless they've added something which, like the castle in the previous map, then this is pretty much it. And it's very nicely done, very pleasant. Feels nicely British. Absolute joy to farm here. Also, you got the signs, the road signs. Bring the map up a second. Okay, so if we go down the back, should find more fields down the bottom. Some nice areas for grass. All in all, this is a very neat, very tidy. Well put together map. Absolute pleasure to play on this map. Well, that's nice. The for sale sign. Did you see that? Go back and look at that. Or let's not. Let's turn around. Pasture, arable, nice. Nice touch, that. I felt that one. Forestry area. Biogas silo area. And similar area for timber. And finally, guys, for this video, we have Drumard, which is an Irish farm. Set in the green fields of Ireland, Colouth, this map is based on real working beef farm. There is a good few fields, small and large, to be worked on. This farm with cows, sheep, pigs and chickens, with two forests. However, the land is expensive, so work hard and use the two sell points to your advantage. There is even additional storage, but it comes with a small fee. Nice. Okay, here we go. So your spawn point is right next to this wheelie bin with some black bin bags. And this poorly animated tiny door. But you look beyond that, and this looks very nice indeed. Oh, look at that, we've even got a border on the map. That's interesting. Okay, so this actually looks fairly similar to one of the previous maps in terms of the central point. Let's jump on a, find a tractor and do a loop. That's a lawnmower. That's not going to get us very far. Gold nuggets. What the heck? There's 99 gold nuggets. Look at this. Automated gates. I found 10 nuggets so far. Well done. Check my map for the locations of the remaining nuggets. There's nuggets everywhere. Oh, I'm not really sure what the point of the nuggets is. Not going to mention leprechauns. So, okay, we found a tractor. Found a tractor. Hello, tractor. Bent 700 Vario. Very nice. Now, I haven't got anything bound to anything. So, am I going to be able to control this? No. Well, it's not attached. I thought it was attached. Okay, that's perfect. We don't really want it on anyway. Let's go. Now all the gates are automatic, so you don't have that annoyance to have to deal with. Oh, I thought the wooden one was the gate. Whoops. Okay, which way should we go here? Let's just check the map again. We'll turn right here and carry on, basically. This is very bouncy. Now, I don't proclaim to know what rural Ireland is like, but I think there must be some similarities between it and the rest of the UK. This is quite nice. This is quite nice. I'm going to have to get my steering sorted out for the next video. Very pleasant. Nice and tight. I'm not sure if there's going to be any AI cars on this or not. Kind of feel like I'm going the wrong way a tad. Yeah, I've ended up in a field. That wasn't part of my plan. Let me just check where I am. How the heck did I end up there? Right, let's turn her around. So it looks to me as though every field is segmented by these bush slash fence combinations. So what I should have done is turn up here. Nope, that's a building. Can I go in there? No. Okay, that's interesting then. Where did I make a wrong turn? Back to the beginning, it must be down there. Okay, it didn't look like a proper road to me, but it must be. It's a rubbish and debris spread about all over the place. Looks like a bit of a forest up the top there. That's quite nice. These fields are very, very undulating, which is a good thing. Yield! Now, I don't know if that's an accurate looking Irish road sign, but it certainly sounds like one. Whoops. Map, sorry. So, yep, turning right here. Thank you. So it looks to me as though the farm shop is down here somewhere. I've probably got that wrong. Looks a bit house. Oh, found a farm. Burp, 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 burp. Hello, chickens. What have we got here? A JCB Fast Track 3000 Extra. Let's continue our tour. Very nice. So obviously I was mistaken. This is a farm and silo. Not the shop at all. I don't know why I thought the shop was down there. This is quite tidy. I mean, it's tight and messy, but in a tidy way. 80 mile an hour limit. Looks like we've got a bridge coming up. Is that the bridge? Wow, that didn't seem like a bridge. It seemed like a hill. Very nice. Again, this is a very British looking T-section, as it were. Now, can I go any further down that way? Nope. Going this way is necessary. And it might seem crazy that at this speed, roads like this would have a speed limit of 50 miles per hour, but actually in the UK that's quite normal. These single lane, oh wow, that's the shop, cool. These single lane roads, incredibly dangerous to drive on even if there are no other vehicles. Generally 50 to 70, perfectly normal. Hey, this is nice. Some people walking around down here. That's where we can sell our eggs. Got the church. Do we have the church sounds? Nope. Nice bus stop. Now this is a nice little feature. I like this. Hello. She said hello. She didn't say hello. He's not nice. What's that over there? How do I get over there? Let's just do one more loop. At the silo. Oh, that's the train yard. Sure what that is. If we look on the map, see if it says. It does, but I can't see a thing. Can you zoom in? I can't even remember how to zoom in. Well, that's kind of it, guys. It's nice. It's there's nothing wrong with it. It's small, it's cramped, it's messy, but all in a good way. Perfectly suits the area it's meant to be in. Oh, I've just spotted the route in. It's here, look. It's tight and it's tricky and it's kind of fun. Don't like games that are too easy. So this is basically where you bring everything, isn't it? Logs, chippings, silage, all comes here. Awesome. Okay, guys, that's it for the videos this week. There's about 20 in total, so I'm going to be doing the next 5 in the next video. And if you enjoyed watching this, enjoyed my content, then please hit the like button. And should you want to see more, then please remember to subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. Until next time, take good care of yourselves. Bye-bye for now.